गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वील सी द यूनिट नंबर 5। इन दैट यूनिट नेम न्यूमेटिक कंपैरेटर एंड कंट्रोल सिस्टम। ओके, इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी पॉइंट। ओके, नॉन रिटर्न वॉल। ओके, दिस वॉल परमिट फ्लो ऑफ एयर इन वन डायरेक्शन। दिस इज direction is blocked or other direction is blocked for air flow at all time. Okay, the following non-return check valve used in non-pneumatic system: first check valve, second shuttle valve, third restrictor check valve, fourth quick exhaust valve, and fifth two pressure valve. Okay, the first there is a diagram of check valve. In that figure shows 5.54. Okay, on achieving the required force to lift a poppet against the spring, air flows in free flow direction. Check valves are installed or installed where different components needs to be isolated so as we allow mutual interference or for safety purpose. Okay, the next diagram is shuttle valve. Okay, this point are used in paper for min times. Okay, this is double check valve. Figure shows 5.5. Okay, in that 5.55 two inlets and one outlets shown in figure. The first position P1 is kept or is loaded by air while P2 is connected to the exhaust. Hence the flows from P1 out to outlet A, and in other one flow in form of P2 to A. Then figure 5.56 shows the use of shuttle valve. In the circuit shown, the movement of a single acting cylinder is controlled by two different valve, but by using and only one at time. Okay, then next point for in the system is exhaust valve. Okay, in this exhaust valve we can say that for working of valve in the position A as shown in the figure, air acts on a curved ceiling of a ceiling close of exhaust port. The port pressure flows gates connected to outlet port A. When the port of control valve is exhausted and exhaust air from a outlet port P to the exhaust air port P from A to R, gaining the rapid direction axis of the pressure instead of having to take a path through a control valve. Obviously this valve is placed directly to the cylinder port. Okay, now we'll see a next point, that is control valve, double acting control valve or double acting cylinder. The figure shows extension and retraction of position is achieved by using three by two valve, whereas the same function is obtained by using 1 5 by 2 valve. Okay, the figure 5.82 and 1 5 by 3 valve 5.83. Okay, the figure shows. In that we can say explanation. The figure 5.81 2 3 by 2 valve are indicated by VA and VB. Both are shown in their normal neutral position. In this position, the position side and rod side air is adjusted to the atmosphere, so the piston is free to move in only one direction or only in any direction. Extension stroke of cylinder can be obtained by shifting the valve VA to position 1 and air is admitted to the piston side. Okay, since the rod side air is exhausted through VB position 0, the extension of piston is allowed. For return stroke valve, VB must be operated to get position 1 and valve VA is operated back to the position 0. Then only return stroke will be permitted. When both valve A and B are position 1, where there is a constant pressure and air pressure on both sides of the piston, a large focus or large force is applied on the full bore area slide as it has large area than the other rod side. The friction and load permits the cylinder will try to extend in the case. The above seems is used for special cylinder application for long stroke valve, may be replaced nearby each port. This reduces the pumping running and distortion. Okay, now we'll see a next explanation, that is pilot ear. Okay, pilot ear in the system, that is the speed control of pneumatic cylinder. In that, first we can say that a large size valve, power valve, for causing actual actuation of actuator are placed near them. Okay, this valve may be controlled by other small pneumatic control valve by providing pilot signal from this valve. The figure 5.85 shows the pilot control valve of double acting cylinder CV1 and CV2 as push button control valve, with PV1 is the valve that gets activated on receiving air signal CV1 and CV2. Okay, working first step, the circuit shows FRL unit pressure gauge. The system pressure is 100 psi while the control valve delivery is a signal of 10 psi for the main valve PV1 actuation. Pressing the push button of CV1 gives its position 1 and position signal PV1 is given and number 2. The position PV1 is actuated. In this position, PV1 is compressed of 100 psi is supplied to a rod end side of the piston extends. The rod end air exhaust to the atmosphere. This position is retained till the pilot signal from CV2 is obtained. Now, second step, pressing CV2 is given position 1 and supplied a pilot signal to the gating number 1, position PV1, in the position the cylinder retracts. Thus, high pressure of air cylinder is utilized control by low pressure push button valve from the place away from the cylinder. In above circuit, it must be noted that after facing the push button of CV1 and CV2 for respectively strokes to taken place, and after release of push button and valve come back to initial spring offset mode 0 position. This permit excitation of pilot signal and actuation or activation of PV1 so that the other side pilot signal is exhausted through CV1 and CV2 to the atmosphere. Also, even after CV1 and CV2 are realized to return stroke their 0 position, the pilot signal and 1 send are memorized and accurate to performance is desired piloted function. Okay, thank you for watching this video.